Hello everyone, welcome or welcome back to my channel. Today I will make a little video about what I take with me when I go on vacation or on a trip, and yeah, let's have a look. To start with the video, I really like this Derwent carry bag. There's a very nice fabric, very sturdy, and it can hold a lot of things you may need when you go on a trip to have all your coloring supplies with you. When you first buy the bag, there are just three leaves in here to put your pencils in, and I ordered some extras, so I also was able to fit all my gel pens that I want to take with me, some blenders and things. But first, let me show you the front of the bag. In the front of the bag, there is a little baggie with a zip. So you can store a lot of your little coloring supplies in here. Goodies like erasers and sharpeners. I have my electric eraser in here. I have a sharpener in here that can hold the shavings. But when I'm on my destination, I always like to use this one because I like it so much more than the Tikal one. And I have my first set of my Neo Color 2 crayons in here. It's used a lot, you can see, and I like to use this side, the lid, as my palette. I just take some crayon, you can see I scribble it down, pick it up with my water brush, and I'm good to go, and it works very nice. So the only thing you need besides it is some paper tissue to clean off your water brush, and that's very handy. Then I also have this little sheet of paper to test out some color combinations, and I have this little Derwent bag in here to store my pencils in when I started the page, and I really like to remember the color combinations that I've used, or if the page is not finished yet, that I can finish it with the right colors when I'm back home. And then I put them in here and I store my pencils in this little bag. I really like it. So to the first side of my pencil bag, the sheet. I have my Mono Zero eraser, and I always make sure there's enough eraser left in here, so you can use it when you need it. I have a bigger eraser here. This is my white Prismacolor. I really like this one. I use it a lot. This is a pencil extender when your pencil is very short. You can put a little nip in here, and it's very nice. Then I have a blender by Caran d'Ache. I don't like this one because it is yellowing over time, and I don't know. I don't like that fact about it. I have my Buff Titanium White color by the Luminance. I really like this color. I use it a lot. Then there is this Derwent blender, a little fine liner. It's by Faber-Castell. It's a size small, and sometimes there is in the coloring book some line work I like to extend or make little changes in my coloring page, and then I use this little fine liner. I have a black Posca pen and a white Posca pen and some gel pens. I really like the gold and the silver one to add little extras on my page. Then on this side I have my little pencil nubbies and things, extenders to use to keep them. When I'm coloring, I'm always looking on this side first if there is a little pencil, and if there's not, I will take a look in the rest of the set. I have my Prismacolors in this one. And one thing to keep in mind is that the Prismacolors break very easily. So when I take this back with me, I always keep it with me. So when I'm in a car, I put it under my seat, so I know the pencils are safe and don't create some broken leads and things. Before I go, I always make sure there is enough pencil left. So when I spot some very tiny pencils, I will replace them already. Then I will put my little one in the front on this sheet, and then I will put a new pencil in. So I'm sure that I'm able to color everything I like at the moment when I'm on holiday. So, yeah, you can see I use it a lot. I'm not sure if I'm able to wash it, but I'm afraid to, ruin it. In the back you have this elastic band, and I like to put my books under it, my coloring books. The only thing is it can only hold a small book, like the Rita Berman. Really nice. It will fit in here. Just pop it in here. I like to put my swatch cards in here. I had a little question about it earlier today in the comments. And I hand draw all my own swatch cards with a pencil and a ruler. So there, you cannot buy it anywhere. Or I just hand draw them on dotted paper and put them in the sheets to protect them. And the thing I really like is that I can take them out my binder and take them everywhere I want. And when I'm done coloring, I can put it back in the binder and keep it there. I put them also in here. And then you can easily close the bag, zip it up, and you have all your coloring supplies with you on the go. And the new Hannah Carlson books also fit very nicely in here. There's some little extra bonus. I like to protect my hardcover books with this flexible book cover to protect it. Because I took my Daydreams book so many times with me, and I noticed they had broken the cover. So there were little chips off my cover and dents, and this one keep my books safe. That's something I really like to do when I take my books with me. So you can see the book is very nice fitting in here. You can put the swatch cards in there and you can zip it up. And that's everything what I need when I go on a trip. And the nice thing about just taking one book with you is that you don't have to sit and think about a lot. Think a lot about what book you want to color and what page you want to start. And because there are not a lot of options, you get more time to color. So I really hope you like the video. I hope to see you next time. Thank you for watching. Bye.